Hi everybody, this is Anastasia from Strapi, and in this video I will show you how to manage end user permissions. Strapi allows you to manage and restrict access to the content APIs and the permissions for end users, meaning the users of the website or app that you're building. There are two ways to manage these permissions, through API tokens or through the Users and Permissions plugin. Let's dive deeper into both options. Token-based authentication became the main way to authenticate and access the content API. It is the best practice for most products, and it is a secure method that does not require user identification or password creation. Tokens store user credentials and permissions. Each token is shared with a user that needs to access the content API. The API tokens became more powerful and granular with the recent update, starting from Strapi v 4.4. Just like with roles and permissions, it is possible to create various API tokens for different levels of permissions. Let's go and see how we can do that. First, click on Settings. In Global Settings, we have the API tokens section. To create a token, we click on this button, where we can write the name of the token, the description, choose a duration, choose a token type, which can be read-only, full access, or custom, and finally set up the permissions. Let's focus more on the different token type. The full access type grants access to perform all actions with all endpoints. The read-only type allows the user to read the endpoints but restricts the other actions. And finally, the custom type allows selecting what kind of actions, create, read, update, and delete, can be performed with each content type endpoint. Let's choose a custom type. And here we can select the exact actions that we can perform with each content type. This granularity is especially useful for projects that use one content source for multiple frontends. For instance, the content from Strapi is delivered to a website and a mobile app. You might need to provide content API access to several frontend developers that work on different projects. In this case, you need to select what exactly they can access and what actions they can perform. Selecting token duration is another important functionality. You can set the time during which the token will be valid. This way, you don't have to worry that someone has access to the API longer than needed. No security vulnerabilities shall pass. Strapi also shows you the token's expiration date, so there is no need to open the calendar. Strapi allows a strong degree of control and security, especially required by large enterprises with projects that involve many people. Another way to authenticate users and grant them access to Content API is through the Users and Permissions plugin. It is not installed by default, as it's only useful for specific use cases. When this plugin is installed, it adds an access layer on your application. The plugin uses JSON Web Tokens to authenticate users. Your JWT contains your user ID, which is matched to the group your user is in and used to determine whether to allow access to the root. Each time an API request is sent, the server checks if an authorization header is present and verifies if the user making the request has access to the resource. Please note that the content must be published to be accessed via the API. By default, two end user roles are defined for any Strapi application. Authenticated, for end users to access content only if they are logged into a front-end application, and public, for end users to access content without being logged into a front-end application. We can also create a new role and define custom permissions. Let's add a new user and see how we can manage the permissions. Once we have created our role, we can add a new user in the Content Manager. Let's go to the User Collection type, create a new entry, add a name, and finally we can choose the role that we have just created. You can use the Users and Permission plugin to share the Access to Content API when your project involves a lot of people who need to access the API using different credentials. For instance, when you're building a platform in which users need to create an account. Thank you for watching this video. By the way, we have a resource center where you can find content on any Strapi-related topic. I hope it will be useful.